Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm reviewing my favorite nibs for intermediate calligraphers. I hesitate to say intermediate just because beginners who are feeling brave could easily use these as well. They're not too tricky, they're just not as simple as the beginner nibs. I posted a video all about my favorite nibs for beginners. If you haven't watched that video, I will link it down in the description below, along with all the nibs I'm using here. I'm turning my paper because it's easier to get an angle on my calligraphy rather than keeping the paper straight. This first nib is the Browse Steno, also known as the Blue Pumpkin. I love this nib for the thicker swells and thin upstrokes. And plus, the Blue Pumpkin is just a fun thing to say. The second one is one of the first nibs I ever purchased, the Hunt 512. This is a great nib. I love that the tines aren't super flexible, so it's really easy to control. The next one is one of my all-time favorites. It is the Mitchell Copperplate Elbow Nib. This one is really fun because the nib itself is oblique shaped. You'll notice I'm using this nib with an oblique holder. The only reason I decided to do this is because the nib fit a little bit better into the oblique holder rather than the straight nib holder. Next is the Hunt 22. I've also seen it listed as the Hunt 22B and the Vintage Hunt 22. I love this nib and I use it all the time. I love the really fine upstrokes and the thicker downstrokes that you achieve with this nib. It glides really smoothly on the paper too. Next is the Tachikawa T600 nib. I haven't used this one a whole lot, which is why the ink isn't really cooperating with me. A good troubleshoot for when the ink isn't working is to use toothpaste and a toothbrush and to make sure all the manufacturing oils are off of the nib. I will also use a soft eraser and just rub off any oils to help the ink stick. Next is the Lennart General Drawing Nib. This nib is so fun to use because of the dramatic, thick swells and the very fine upstrokes. When the ink runs out and the tines separate like this, I just go back and fill in the downstroke. And when I went back over the L, too much of the ink carried over to my upstroke, so I'm just going to try writing my hello again so that you can see how this nib is really supposed to write. Then we have the Lennart 33 nib. This nib also has the thicker downstrokes, but doesn't have quite as thin of an upstroke. Still really fun to use. Last is the Hunt 104. I love this teeny guy. I want to remember I have this for when my kids start losing teeth. And then I can write tiny letters from the tooth fairy. How fun would that be? I also wanted to keep the hello the same size as the others I've written out so that you can see what this nib would write like full size. I absolutely love how dainty and delicate it makes my lettering look. Let me know down in the comments what your favorite calligraphy nib is. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe. I post a new calligraphy video every Monday and a new watercolor video every Wednesday. If you would like free calligraphy guides, sign up for my newsletter. Just visit www.snowberrydesignco.com/subscribe to sign up. I will leave a link in the description down below for that as well. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!